This isn't a Nintendo Switch. It's a Christmas ornament. Let's start from the beginning, and I'll show you how I built it. Making electronic Christmas ornaments is nothing new, but I've been obsessed with the idea ever since seeing Tom Archer's fireplace ornament. His design is gorgeous, using the white silkscreen layer, exposed copper, and even variations of copper designs underneath the red solder mask to create a variety of colors and textures. My problem was that I'm not very good at graphic design, so building something like this was out of my league. I needed to take another approach, and my inspiration started with a small LCD screen, an even smaller ESP32 microcontroller module, and a new online 3D printing service that was too cheap to ignore. I don't actually remember why I decided to make a Nintendo Switch, but the first step was to create a simplified model. Luckily, it's pretty much just a rounded rectangle with some circles for buttons, so it was easy enough to sketch in Fusion 360. I shrunk it about 5:1 and overlaid it on the LCD model since this was the most important size constraint. The custom circuit board was the next big task. I drew the outline for the PCB in Fusion 360, following the shape of the body, but added a little loop that sticks out from the corner so you can hang the ornament. To keep the body and PCB attached to one another, I added tabs on one end of the body and a little clip on the other end. I wanted to make the Joy-Con thumbsticks clickable, so I found these absolutely tiny buttons on DigiKey. I couldn't believe how small they were when they arrived, but apparently they're normally used in small devices like hearing aids. These buttons will get 3D printed button caps to mimic the look of the thumbsticks. Since those button caps were so small, I duplicated them into a grid to print as a single piece that could be snapped apart. I designed the PCB itself and the electronics using KiCad, which was mostly just an exercise in trying to fit too many parts in too little space. To fit everything on the board, I ended up getting creative, I guess you could say, and snuck a few resistors inside the SD card slot. Maybe not an ideal location, but there was plenty of room to spare, and the top of the card reader opens in case I need to access them later. At this point, my design was ready for manufacturing, so I double-checked all the internal dimensions in Fusion 360 before sending the PCB and STL files to be manufactured. A few weeks later, a package arrived, so it's time to assemble the PCB. Since this has a bunch of small components, I'm going to use reflow soldering rather than hand soldering each joint with a soldering iron. I start by surrounding the board with other PCBs of the same thickness to hold it steady and to provide a flat surface for the solder stencil to sit on. The stencil's openings are aligned with the PCB's copper pads, and I tape it in place to act as a hinge. Then I apply some solder paste and squeeze it through the openings in the stencil onto the PCB. After that, it's time to place the components onto the solder paste, starting with the smallest capacitors and resistors. And then moving on to the bigger components, like this MOSFET, the micro SD card holder, and finally the ESP32 module. The populated PCB gets put on a hot plate where it's heated to 220 degrees Celsius over several minutes. Once the solder paste reaches its melting point, you can see it liquefy and fuse the components to the PCB in real time. You can even see the surface tension of molten solder pull some of the components into alignment, like this capacitor. Since I could only reflow one side of the board, I hand soldered the buttons and LCD that go on the front. I also added these super flexible silicone insulated wires, which will both power the finished ornament and act as the string used to hang it from a branch. The power will come from a micro USB to 3.3 volt adapter that you can tuck away in the tree. I'm going to program this ESP32 using the Arduino framework, but you might have noticed that there's no room for a USB port on this thing. So instead, I'll actually be programming it with an external USB programmer, using these 6 test points I left along the side. I 3D printed a jig to align 6 spring-loaded pogo pins with those test points, and downloaded the first program. After a little more programming, I got the LCD working and added a library to play animated GIFs from the SD card. you can switch between GIFs by clicking the left thumbstick. With built-in Wi-Fi, the ESP32 will check the date and time so it can automatically play different GIF files on Christmas Day. I've included a link to the code in the video description below if you're curious how it works. The switch body was SLA printed in semi-translucent resin, and everything came out great. This was my first time trying an SLA print, and the level of detail is incredible. The thumbstick button caps even snapped apart as I hoped. I gave it a quick spray of white primer, followed by a few coats of hand-painted acrylic for the iconic neon blue and red Joy-Cons, and finally a few small touches of black. Everything snaps together, and now all that's left is to hang it on the tree. I have to say that this really is a testament to what's possible with hobbyist electronics and mail order 3D printing these days. Thanks for watching, and Merry Christmas!